So dear students, let's discuss about the legislative assembly's functions and powers. So first, an important power of legislative assembly is legislative powers. It means it can make the laws on the state list and concurrent list. State list is a list on that the state government can make the laws. There are 66 subjects on which our state government can take the decision. For what kind of issues? Such as health services, education, trade and commerce. These are the subjects, and some other subjects are also there on which state government can make the laws. And also there is concurrent list. On that, both the state government and the union government can make the laws. But as our union government is more powerful, if there is conflict between two governments, then the decision of the central government will be implemented. Then financial powers. It means it can be take the decision about the finance or money of the state. It means it passes the annual budget for the state, and they can take the decision about the how much money will be used for the health services, how much money will be used for the education, etc. So these are the decisions which can be taken at the time of passing budgets. And then it can impose a new tax also if there is need. It can abolish or remove the previous tax, or it can reduce the amount that was previously taken by the state government. Then constitutional powers. It means the power related to constitution. If there is need to make some change or some changes in the constitution, then the members of the parliament and the members of the legislative assemblies take the part in the amendment process and make the changes in the constitution. For example, earlier Jammu Kashmir was having the special status under the Article 370, and it was a threat to our unity. That's why our government has taken the decision to take off the special status of Jammu and Kashmir. And this became possible through the amendment process that was taken collectively by the members of parliament and the members of the legislative assembly. And now Jammu Kashmir is having the is the union territory of India, because union government can control the terrorist activities held in the Jammu Kashmir. That's why this change in the constitution is possible due to the amendment process. Then electoral powers. Electoral power means some members of the, like 1/3 members of the legislative councils are elected by the legislative assembly members, and then it can take part in the election of the president of India also. Then the speaker and deputy speaker of the legislative assembly are elected by the members of the legislative assembly also. For example, the Gyanchand Gupta is the speaker of Haryana legislative assembly, and he is elected by the members of the legislative assembly of Haryana. Then executive powers. It means it can make the council of minister responsible to the legislative assembly. How it can be possible? The legislative assembly members, means MLA, can ask the question from the minister related to particular issue. For example, from the health minister of Haryana, it can be asked by the other ministers what decisions have been taken for the curing the patients of COVID-19. So they are responsible to the MLAs and Legislative Assembly, and they have to answer for these decisions. And if they are not doing such kind of activities for welfare of the people, they can be motivated for that. And they can also have the attention motion, and they can have the attention of Council of Minister for the particular issue. Then Legislative Council, this is the upper house of the legislature of the state, and 1/3 members of the Legislative Council are elected by the Legislative Assembly, and some members are elected by the local bodies, and some members are elected by the government teachers, and some members are elected by the graduates of the states. Then State Executive, it means there are two executive of the states. One is the real. For example, real executive is that who is taking political powers in reality. For example, Manohar Lal Khattar is the Chief Minister of Haryana, and he is in reality taking all the decision on the advice of governor. But in reality, decisions are taken by the Chief Minister. And other is nominal. Nominal means the person is exercising the political power in the formal way. Means actually decisions are taken by the real executive, that is the Chief Minister. And nominal is the governor. And who is the governor of Haryana? Satyadev Narayan Arya. So he is the nominal executive of the state.